If you're not the lead dog, the view is always the same. You're looking at someone else's ass, okay? So in business, you have to understand that it's not just, hey, I focus on my product, I focus on my marketing, I focus on whatever that I'm doing now, but it's very, very important to stay relevant, to stay on the cutting edge. So what are some of the things that you can do to stay innovative in business or in marketing? Now you can see, if you follow my work, I'm always testing new ideas. I'm pushing the envelope. I'm coming up with new ideas. Doesn't matter if it's an ad, doesn't matter if it's a piece of content, doesn't matter if it's an Iron Man, it doesn't really matter, right? I want to incorporate different things I do, because in order to get attention from the marketplace, you don't want to be boring. Being boring is the biggest sin in marketing. Because if people are not paying attention to even your message, they're not even paying attention to your brand, they're not gonna buy from you, period, right? So what are some of the things that I do personally, and what are the things I recommend that you could do to stay innovative? Number one, and that is, keep your friends close, but keep your enemy even closer. You should know your competitors. First of all, you gotta know who the hell are your competitors. Right? Who are your top 5, 10 competitors? Those primary competitors, how well do you know their business? How well do you know them? What are their offers? What changes are they making? You should be on their mailing list. You should be on their email list. You should be watching what they're doing, not because you could copy them, but because you want to know, you want to keep a pulse. What moves are they making, right? You have to know. So you have to observe and pay attention. You should know your competitors more than they know themselves. You should know what they're working on, what marketing initiative they're doing, what new product are they launching. You have to keep an eye constantly. So know that, hey, what are some of the things that you need to do within your company so you can be innovative? Number two, understand the difference between being inventive versus innovative. They're two different things, because a lot of people, they confuse the two. Being inventive, meaning that you invent a new thing, a new idea, an original idea. No one's ever seen this before, right? It's a brand new thing. It's revolutionary. That's being inventive. Now, some entrepreneurs, they do very well. They make a lot of money being inventive. Maybe they're inventors. But most entrepreneurs are actually more innovative versus being inventive, meaning that they are looking at what other people are doing, and they can see, how can I make the connection? A lot of people, they say that I'm a great synthesizer, I'm a great connector, meaning that I'm not the guy that comes up with breakthrough original idea, but I'm very good at observing ideas that works in what seem to be industries that are not relevant. And I'm able to make those connections. Say, hey, that's interesting. That works for this particular industry, or that works for that particular business, that works for this sector. That, okay, maybe I can borrow that idea into this business. No one's ever done that before. You think about an example. Think about the drive-through example, right? Drive-through has been around a long time. Fast food, you know what I'm talking about, right? Well, it's only after so many years someone thought about, hey, you know what? You could have the drive-through for fast food. Why couldn't you have drive-through for banking? Because people go in the bank, in and out so much all the time, they don't have to park. They just want to do a quick deposit or quick withdrawal. Why not just pull up my card, da-doot, in and out? I don't need to park, line up at the bank, and do all of that stuff. From the bank's point of view, more transaction fees, makes more money, don't need as many people, don't need as many tellers. There you go. That's not an inventive idea. It's not being, oh, it's been around a long time, but someone saw them, then someone is innovative enough to say, hey, that's something that we could do in banking. Boom, there you go. That's a great idea. Very, very profitable idea. That's being innovative. What you want to do is to go out of your industry and look at other industries. Example, attend trade shows that are outside your industry. Trade shows that has nothing to do with what you do. And just see what other people are doing. One of the things that I like to do is I like to read blog posts or articles, newsletters, and magazines from industries that I know nothing about. I would pick up a gardening magazine. Like, I would pick up a magazine on games. I would pick up a magazine on something else, on technology. Just something that just totally out of the box. Because how are you gonna get out of the box idea? By staying in the box, you can't. If you look at what everyone else is doing in the industry, and yes, you want to keep your enemies close, but at the same time, you're studying things outside of your typical norm. You're trying to defy conventional wisdom to find ways to do things that nobody's ever done in your industry. That's how you create disruption. You do that by feeding your mind with information and content that you don't usually consume. It's a very, very simple thing. And when you read those things, maybe you're like, I don't understand. It's okay. But something would hit you. An idea is like, wow, that's interesting. That's odd. Like, I've never thought about that. And it makes you ponder. It makes you think. That's how you stay innovative. Number three, the best way, the absolute best way to stay innovative and also stay relevant in business or in marketing is to hang out with other successful entrepreneurs outside of your industry. Maybe go to that event, right? Go to that association, join different groups, meet with them, talk with them, have lunch, have dinner, hear from them, ask about, hey, what are you doing? What are you working on? What are the new things you're working on? You might get a new idea for a business model. You might make that connection, or you might get a new strategy or a new process of doing something. Those little golden nuggets, you will not be able to get those things staying in your bubble. By staying at home, by staying in your office, you need to go out there and get them. And that's how you get new ideas that will take your business to a whole new level. I'm talking about that one elegant idea, and one elegant idea is better than 1,000 lousy ideas. One elegant idea that could completely transform your business. So those are the three ways what you need to do to stay innovative. And always remember, just because you are doing well today, just because everything is good today, don't let your guard down. It doesn't take a lot for someone to come along and grab market share. It doesn't take a lot for someone to steal customers from you. It doesn't take a lot for consumers, because consumers are very demanding, they're very unforgiving, to say, hey, I'm not gonna buy from you anymore. Now I'm gonna buy from somebody else. You've seen that before. Companies from here, top of their game, within a short period of time, I'm not talking about decades, I'm talking about a few years, sometimes a few months, from here to here, very, very quickly. So it is your job as an entrepreneur, as a leader, to stay innovative, to stay on the cutting edge, to do what it takes, to know what's ahead, what's coming, what's upcoming trend. It is your duty, it is your obligation, because a lot of people are counting on you.